Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte reiterates the province of Cebu cannot be exempted from following national quarantine protocols. Cebu has been insisting on a shortened facility-based quarantine period and testing upon arrival for overseas travelers arriving at their international airport. But an infectious disease expert asserts the 10-day quarantine, a COVID testing on the seventh day, should be the way to go.
At this time of a national emergency, I would just like to inform the courts that I will not follow them. I leave the fate of Governor Garcia's DILG. Itong pandemic kasi, it's a national emergency, or whatever is recommended and approved by me remains to be obeyed. Sabihin talaga nila ng ang task force that you have to go into a quarantine for 10 days. Hanggang hindi nagbago yan, wala tayong magawa.
The Delta variant is really very scary, and this is all the more reason why we really should police our borders po. Kasi it only takes one variant to get in, and then pwedeng mag-India-like surge po tayo kasi mataas po talaga yung number of people na kayang i-infect ng isang taong merong Delta variant. Kung yung dating virus po natin, yung original virus, dalawa lang po yung nai-infect, itong Delta variant up to 8 po. So it's up to 4 times more contagious than the original virus from Wuhan po.
On Monday, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia stood her ground on the quarantine guidelines, saying local governments should enjoy local autonomy. Two Cebu-based lawyers also filed a petition before the Cebu City Regional Trial Court, seeking to stop the enforcement of the Interagency Task Force's 10-day facility-based quarantine.
The provincial ordinance, which adopted the protocols that I set forth in Executive Order 17, is the law of the land at this point in time, because no one has questioned it, no one has gone to court, much less has it been declared ultra vires by a proper court. We are a government of laws, not of men. And so it is not about someone saying that the provincial ordinance is null and void because it goes against a particular resolution issued by IATF.
The mandatory use of face shields in public areas here in the Philippines stays. President Rodrigo Duterte settled the debate over the matter Monday night, citing the advice of health experts. He said face shields would serve as extra protection over the threat posed by the more transmissible COVID-19 Delta variant. He added, the policy should be followed by everyone in both indoor and outdoor settings.
I will apologize to the Filipino people that this thing was being discussed openly. I'm constrained really to go back to the old practice because of this danger posed by the D variant. Kung wala lang sana yan, especially I said with the narratives that goes with it in the international news and even dito sa locally, it's scary. So I cannot afford to place the nation, the national interest of the Republic by just, sometimes adopting this and being lenient to this. I said, I know that it is a very tedious, if you may, but it is really to prevent a disaster of our nation.
Health experts welcome the president's decision.
The Delta variant is also 40% more infectious outdoors, 60% more infectious indoors. So it would be nice po to have an extra layer of security.
There are actually several findings from studies conducted by different teams, kasama na po yung grupo ni Drs. Chu et al. And this is published internationally. And they indicated that meron pong evidence that eye protection such as face shields actually are able to reduce 78% infection such as through the ocular route, which occurs either by droplet or aerosol or self-inoculation.
Speaking of the COVID-19 Delta variant, four more Filipinos tested positive for it on Monday. Three of them are seafarers who were repatriated on June 3rd, two of which have since recovered, while the other one is still confined in a Metro Manila hospital. The fourth case is a returning Filipino from Saudi Arabia who arrived last May 24th. He recovered on June 10 and is now under home quarantine. These raise the total number of Filipinos infected with the more transmissible variant from India to 17.
So ang ating UK variant, ito pong Alpha variant, sinabi na dati that it's 60% more transmissible. Pero sinabi, ang Delta variant is 60% more transmissible than the Alpha variant. So ibig sabihin po, kung ang Alpha variant ay nakapanghahawa ng mga 4 hanggang 5 tao for every individual infected, ang Delta variant po can have about 8 individuals infected, no? Sa isang taong may sakit. Sinasabi na yung probabilidad mo na ma-hospital ka kapag Delta variant ang nakuha mong virus ay mataas. Meron din pong sinasaad, no, doon sa ibang studies na nakita natin na merong paghaba ng pagkaka-hospital or prolongation of hospitalization kasama po dito sa epekto nitong variant na ito.
The Philippines also detected 14 new cases of the Alpha variant first found in the UK and 21 new carriers of the Beta variant from South Africa.
The Health Department also reported 5,249 new cases of the original COVID-19 strain Monday, the lowest daily tally in nearly 2 weeks. This brings the nationwide total to over 1,364,000. Active infections stand at 55,847, the lowest in 12 days. The death toll, meanwhile, climbed to 23,749 after 128 more people succumbed to the disease.